After watching this tutorial, you will be able to solve any number of equations in MATLAB. I'm gonna introduce these commands, fzero for a single equation and fsolve for a system of equations. The general form of fzero is x equals to fzero function handle comma x0. So it takes only a function and a starting point, which is your first guess. It finds the zeros of the function, so the right hand side is always 0. Let's solve this equation. I create a function named f with x and y as input and output. I advise you to vectorize your expressions. Now that I have the function, I can type solution equals to f0 at sign f comma 0. And that's my solution. I plot the function and I see that this equation has two answers. If I change the initial guess, I will get the other one. I could use anonymous or inline functions too. If you don't know how to define anonymous or inline functions, check out my video on defining functions. Before we proceed to next part, here are a few notes on how to use f0. f0 only finds the intersection of your function with the x-axis. So if the function touches the x-axis but doesn't cross it, as in this example, f0 cannot find the solution. If you initially know an interval in which the function crosses x-axis, use that interval as your first guess. Just remember that the function must have different signs in these points. Now we want to solve a system of nonlinear equations numerically. If you want to solve the equations symbolically, check out my tutorial on MATLAB symbolic toolbox. The general form of fsolve is solutions equal to fsolve function handle comma x0. Since we want to solve a system of equations, here the output of this function must be a vector containing each equation, and x0 is a vector containing the initial guesses. Look at this example. Find the intersection coordinates of this ellipse with this parabola. I also plot them to show the intersections. I go back to my function definition. Output equals to f of xy. This vector is xy and this is the output. X squared 4th plus y squared minus 1 semicolon y minus 4 times x squared plus 3. The problem is we still haven't defined x and y. They are stored inside this variable. So I define x and y. X equals to the first element of xy and y is the second one. Now I can use fsolve at sign f, 0, 0. I plot the answer. I can find the other answer by changing the initial guess. Let's solve another problem. Solve these two equations for theta 1 and theta 2. Again, my function receives the unknowns in a vector which I call theta, and the equations are stored in a vector as the output. Solutions equals to fsolve at sign f, pi sixth, pi sixth. And that's it. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please subscribe to my channel.